This Battle Ballcast is brought to you by Mr. Magic Down Under and DiceRemover.com.
This is round one of the daily event and I won the die roll. Someone go first. One lander I can't keep. Oh, it's a shame. Would be really interesting. Can keep, but I don't like. I will open with the vault in case he's playing some sort of green or black deck. I'll kind of regret it if he's playing red though. Yeah, I knew it. Ah, sigh. Alright. A land. I do need land. I really dislike taking 2 damage from my own land next turn. Okay, what do you have for me? Yes, that seems fair enough. What do I draw? Temple. Let's go create my blocker. Main deck Searing Blood. That's not good. Me anyway. Ooh, another Phoenix. I feel like if I use Phoenix Star, I'll probably get hit by his striker. Yeah, he wasn't gonna do anything anyway. If he has two of the blood rushing guys, then yeah, he's got a pretty good hit on me. Can't say I'm too pleased with this draw. But I'll make it work somehow, hopefully. I can still recover if I can draw some Wally Helixes or something.
Thought he could,
Searing blood again. Nope, not this time. Rabble Master. No, not Rabble Master. Still annoying though. I go down to, if he's playing Phoenixes, sometimes he's playing extra burns, he's not playing Rebel Master version. This is probably just Red Deck Wounds. That does make this matchup slightly harder though. It means I'll be dealing with Boris Reknos next turn. Okay, here we go. Do not want the Midabot. Yeah, I knew it. I definitely mislabeled him. One, two, three, four. I can shoot his creature and see what I draw next turn. Alright, we'll try that. No. Cancel! Cancel! How do I cancel this? Undo. Okay, let's try this again. Hitting the Phoenix. It is very possible for me to claw my way back through this game. Problem is, now I'm going to be expecting land destruction, Boros Reknos. Very irritating matchup. Does he have the removal spell? Yeah, GG. Okay, well, I'm bringing in my own Searing Bloods. I'm cutting out the Phoenixes. I'll cut out all my creatures for now, and I'll think about it. Barashlam's actually okay in this matchup, to be honest. Okay, sort by converted mana cost. Definitely want the chains. I'll try my usual strategy of dances and young pyromancers. Though he's playing a heavy burn style, which makes his strategy a little bit weaker than it normally is. Glare of Heresy or Raise the Alarm? I'm actually gonna go for Glare because of a hunch I have.
Hold and be
I should, however, probably cardboard out my young pyromancers. No, I should probably board out my dancers and actually just play no, young pyromancers, and go for a more burn approach. Let's see how my teammate's going right now. Nah, I couldn't find him. I can keep this hand. Having glare early is good because that'll mean I won't waste my chain rocks on a one of those early cards for no reason. Does he have not one drop? He does. How frustrating. I will go for the turn 2, young pyromancer. Land, please. Just need one more land and I'm safe. Searing Blood. Please, not Searing Blood. Nah, he has it. Pretty big turn. Shock's an excellent draw. I missed the combat step, so I couldn't actually kill it before he pumps it. Brawl Shark, not do it. There's a small chance, very tiny, that I may have mislabeled him. Nah, he must be playing it. Yeah, I mislabeled him. He's playing Red Deck Wounds, but he's not playing Boss Reckoners. Which is very unusual. Come on, Sandra, I need to draw her soon. That's pretty annoying. Skullcrack? Yep. The good thing though is now he's down to one card. Bad thing is now, if I draw Sandra now, she'd be kind of dead. This also meant I should have played the Young Pyromancer earlier. Land, please. This is a very greedy play. Playing in my Glare of Heresy was such a mistake. The good thing is I know what card to cut now, it's pretty obvious. Hit me, of course. Hitting Sandra would be wrong. Yep, that's the correct play. GG. Good. I won even though I made really poor choices. So there goes my Glare of Heresies. I'm now on the draw, so I definitely need to protect my lands. My real estate. Borrow Charm suddenly seems really good. Do I cut Young Pyromancers or Twilight Dancers for additional Boros Charms? No, I think 2 Boros Charms is the correct number. Here we go. So I don't want to draw too many aggressive spells, even though Boros Charm can be used aggressively and defensively. One Land Devil of Shock. Can keep, but it's so bad. Should've kept the last hand. Land, please. Mountain. ETE? Okay. Into A. Another one. Alright, what else? Lightning Strike? Yep. Okay. So now he's down to 2 cards. Land, please. Problem is, now I'm vulnerable to LD. I can chain, but doing so will run many risk. Yeah, Ravi use Lightning Strike. Land. I'm gonna hate seeing an LD. Land, please. Oh, come on, why does it have to be that land? Sandra, at the very least. There you go, LD time. Oh, he was playing Boss Reckoner. How wonderful. Sandra, come on! Yeah. Using Shock was probably a mistake. It may have been better for me to use some Stokes and Flames there. Sandra. Okay, I can finally attack. But attacking may actually open me up to Searing Bloods. Oh, that works. I will actually Stokes myself if he does play Searing Blood. Okay, this is the part where all those lands kill me. Alright. I can take out two lands. Not sure how much land will help me though. You can still make two more. Okay. That's a good draw, finally. Yeah, you got more land. Need chains or something for that. Should be targeting me actually, that would be the correct play. Yeah. Oh dear, it's a good draw. Basically, you need to draw Helix now or I lose. Good game.